劲儿。So don't move until I say action.
That's where it started, but this is all about where it ends.I honestly can't remember a day where I wasn't making videos. It's always been my one passion. Growing up, I obsessed over YouTubers who got to do it for a living. It seemed like the ultimate dream. And so when I graduated high school, I reached what I call survival mode. I wasn't gonna accept any other kind of future for myself. So I dropped out of university and worked hard to make it happen. And in just over a year, I surpassed 1 million subscribers at the age of 19. I achieved everything I thought I wanted. I was getting recognition from all my heroes, my work was being viewed by millions,and I've become a part of a world that I fantasized about since I was a kid. But my brain didn't handle that success well or privately. It created a severe anxiety in me that took years to get a handle on. It was very confusing to me that the one thing that made me so happy was also the reason I was so depressed. And so eventually I just stopped creating. And it wasn't until then that I was finally able to process why. With every passion comes a grind. Consistency is key. This is especially true when you first start.You need to create a momentum for yourself. Some are better at this than others. Some even become addicted to the rhythm of it all. But ultimately, I think everyone ends up asking themselves the same question. How long can I last? Unfortunately, I think the pace you need to maintain on social media is something I can't keep up with, especially as it becomes more and more saturated. And what made it all more anxiety-inducing was having the measurement of my success be so public.Made me feel like that somehow equated to the value of my work, too. It pushed me to constantly top myself creatively and quickly, which ultimately burnt me out. I want to reiterate that this is just my personal experience. I have lots of friends who are good at playing the game and enjoy it, too, but I don't. And I think it's okay to leave it at that. Now, what I've created on this channel is a time capsule.And as cool as that is, I can't really watch my old videos back. I find it very hard. Mostly because I can barely recognize the person I used to be. I mean, I started all this when I was a kid, and now I'm 24 years old. I'm a completely different person now. But there is something very beautiful about being able to watch myself grow up in videos that not only document my physical growth, but my emotional growth too. But also very scary, because you could all watch them too.I think the part that trips me out the most is that the memories that I've blocked out of my head to move forward with my life still live on for all you to see. So if I could tell my younger self one thing, it's that we're all ever-changing. And to just remember that putting a moment in time on the internet makes that version of you solidify forever. The cool thing about social media platforms is that it's a raw and direct connection to an audience. It's personal. It makes people feel like they know you. It makes you feel like you're understood.And in a weird way, you become the main character. But there are a lot of layers to the damages making my life so public has had on me, including a lot of the relationships in my life. These are things I can't undo, which led me to the biggest breakthrough I had about creating. I don't want my life to be the product anymore. My friend Tomska said this quote once, and it really stuck with me. But not everyone deserves your vulnerability. And as much as I know that now,A lot of my past traumas are still public knowledge, and that's just something I'm going to continue to navigate and heal from for the rest of my life. That all being said, I am coming to peace with it, and I can look back at it all as just a chapter in my life. But moving forward, I'd rather tell my stories and perspectives in ways that aren't at the expense of my privacy. Hi guys, thank you for coming. I hope you guys enjoy Reply.Around this time a year ago, I made a short film. It was my first time directing, and it was definitely a turning point in my life. The feeling I felt on set was something I never experienced before. Getting to bring to life a universe and characters that I came up with in my head was honestly drug-like. And so since rapping, I've been working nonstop to make that happen for myself again. The experience made me realize what I want to do for the rest of my life.And the only other time I felt this feeling was when I decided I was going to become a full-time YouTuber. And so I'm very happy to share that my short film is finally being released into the world on this amazing platform called Creator Plus. So to get a taste of what's to come, be sure to check out my directorial debut reply out this Thursday on the Creator Plus app or creatorplus.com. Hello. This feels weird. So I was thinking about how I explain my YouTube channel to people, and I usually say, imagine if Ferris Bueller had a YouTube channel, which is ironic because I never lived by his most famous quote. Life moves pretty fast. If you don't stop and look around once in a while, you can miss it. And so I've seen this past year as me finally stopping to smell the roses, and in doing so, with the help of therapy, I finally appreciate everything I've done so far. And I think this is the first time in my life I've been able to say that. So if you've been along for the ride, whether that be from the start or just for part of it, I wanted to say thank you. Seriously, it means a lot to me that you cared. I know this may feel like a goodbye, but it really isn't. I'm still gonna be making shit. I think I'd like to see this more as like my High School Musical 3 moment. Not trying to close the door shut here, but instead just introduce you guys to a whole new beginning, you know? And today is January 22nd, 2017, and today is the day I changed my life.